So Jay, thanks you for joining me today.
Happy to be here.
Super. So you are one of the supply chain planning experts from the SAP side, and you're working in the solution management team. You have very strong focus on sales and operations planning, demand-driven MRP, and one of your topics at heart is also how to bring in financial aspects or financial planning aspects into the supply chain planning processes.
That is true.
So, from your perspective or from your point of view, so what do you see customers struggling with these days? In which direction are they looking at?
Well, I think we start with the reality that we're seeing signs of stabilization finally in global supply chains. Inventories are rising and companies are getting a little bit calmer when supply chain is concerned. There's still some pockets of stress in certain supply chains in certain industries, but in general that intense and panic focus on supply chain execution seems to be abating. The financial impact of all those extraordinary activities that all these customers did to meet customer demands is starting to be recognized on the bottom line. Focus is now turning to better alignment between the financial targets of the company and its ongoing business activities. Companies are starting to focus more on getting back on track financially, improving their bottom lines and cash flow, and optimizing their working capital. This is especially important as the cost of money and subsequently the cost of doing business is going up.
Yeah, that's all valid points. So how do customers tackle these challenges that we see right now?
Well, first off, this isn't a new problem or a new area of interest. When we were suffering these global supply chain disruptions, companies were doing whatever was necessary to meet customer obligations or take advantage of new market opportunities. But prior to that, there was a disconnect between those processes. In other words, the aligned connection between planning and execution was broken, and finance. So let me use a specific example about financial planning in a company that's also known as FP&A. It performs a very important function for the company. It provides cash for operations, projects profit and loss, provides financial reporting and guidance for the company. It really tries to manage the company for the future. There's also another process that goes on in a company known as IBP, or Integrated Business Planning, which really drives the operational activities of the company. And oftentimes, more often than we would like, those respective plans are not in sync. And as we've eased out of the supply chain crisis, companies are returning to those efforts to repair or eliminate that broken connection. There are structured planning processes that are put in place now and new technologies to put in place to help align those different company business functions. And along with that, there's a brand new term that's been introduced to the market called Extended Planning and Analysis, or now a new acronym, xP&A.
Oh, I see. So xP&A is basically kind of the synchronization of the financial planning with other operational planning aspects in a company.
Yeah.
Is this more about financial control or really financial planning?
Well, close. It's actually providing financial representation of all the operational planning activities and decisions that happen to the FP&A process. It's also including the finance function in operational planning activity, so it goes both ways. It's not finance trying to take over operational planning, it's trying to align the two processes to provide better overall results.
So Jay, SAP has two very distinct planning solutions that play a role in our scenario here in supply chain. We are looking at SAP Analytics Cloud for planning for the financial planning aspects, as well as SAP Integrated Business Planning for the supply chain planning aspects. Both have very distinct planning capabilities that they are leveraging. Can you elaborate on that for a second?
Yeah, sure. So first off, xP&A is not a new topic for SAP. Over the years, we call this concept connected planning, extended planning, collaborative enterprise planning, and possibly a few more that I've forgotten. But to support the concept, we have provided mapped integration between the two solutions you mentioned, connecting them at logical points to support that end-to-end process, and that's available today. And as you said, they are powerful solutions targeted towards specific business activities.
I see. So xP&A is really an evolving topic. So how do our solutions need to evolve to constantly support the new requirements that we hear from the customers?
Well, I think you said it right. It's an evolving topic. The definition seems to be moving, but we at SAP are continuing to explore ways to more tightly integrate the processes and the solutions to improve collaboration between the business functions for our customers. But more importantly, we're going to preserve and protect those advanced functionalities that exist in each solution. At the same time, we want to provide improved collaboration between these functions and technical business functionalities. Our promise is to serve our customers better and help them succeed with their business.
Sounds like an exciting roadmap ahead of us.
Very
and
exciting.
Already existing today. I know we have customers who are leveraging these solutions to run their end-to-end financial and supply chain planning today. And we hope to see more in this area. Very exciting news. And we'll add some information for you to follow up in this video. And yeah, thank you for tuning in. And we hope to see you back in the next video.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.